Mr. Lim Biao-chuan, and Mr. Edwin Tong asked about appeal transfers after Secondary 1 posting exercise. Our transfer process must be fair and transparent. The Secondary 1 posting exercise is conducted based on PSLE performance. Hence, principals will consider appeals only if the student has met the school's cutoff point. For those who do not meet the cutoff point, flexibility will be exercised if they have medical or special needs or if there are exceptional circumstances. Over 400 of our students appealed successfully last year and obtained a school transfer according to their school preferences. Our secondary schools do not only admit students based on cutoff points. The direct school admission DSA scheme was set up to allow schools to recognize and admit students based on a more diverse range of talents and achievements beyond what the PSLE recognizes. Many students take up the DSA because they want to further nurture their talents and strengths through specific programs in schools. At St. Teresa's, I saw how hard the Theresian hockey team fought to win a friendly match. A few hockey players I saw told me they joined the school via DSA because they had fell in love with hockey at primary school and wanted to further develop their talent through the strong hockey team at St. Teresa's. Like the Theresians who chased their passion, Kishan Venudas joined Evergreen Secondary via DSA. He wanted to nurture his passion and talent in English through their communication program. When Kishan was in Sec 2, he won the silver medal at the National School's Literature Festival Poetry Slam. Now, he's a JC 2 student. He continues his passion of studying literature at A-level and conducts public poetry recitals at school. These examples illustrate the intent of our DSA scheme and how students have benefited by taking ownership of their education choices. Mr. Ang Wei Neng asked for a breakdown of the DSA admission numbers in 2016. I would like to first clarify that schools received 16,000 applications last year, with some students applying to more than one school. It means many students actually make multiple applications. So eventually, a total of 2,800 students were admitted to secondary school via DSA, half of which were to the integrated program or IP. This is not surprising, given that IP schools have full discretion in admission, while the majority of our secondary schools can only set aside 5, 10, 20% of the secondary one intake for DSA places today, depending on the type of school. Our schools, I agree with Mr. Ang, have robust distinctive programs. For example, the applied learning programs, the Learning for Life programs are designed in consultation with industry partners to offer more authentic learning experiences so that we can do more to help students take advantage of these programs via DSA in all schools to pursue their interests. Starting from 2018, we will expand the number of DSA places so that all secondary schools can admit up to 20% of their secondary one non-integrated program intake via DSA. With this expansion, students can better assess schools with suitable programs via DSA to nurture their strengths, talents, and interests. As what Mr. Edwin Tong has pointed out, DSA should not be seen as an entry ticket to popular schools, but it is also a mutual commitment between the school and the student, and the child will have to complete the DSA application process before the release of the PSLE results. We will also make changes to DSA processes. First, we will refine DSA selection. Today, all applicants who apply for a particular DSA category in a school go through the same selection that is open and merit-based. That selection matches a student's strengths and interests to a school talent development program and ensures that students are able to cope with the academic rigor of the school program. We will start refining the DSA selection from this year to better achieve the objectives of DSA. Schools will focus on identifying students with specific talents and move away from recognizing strong general academic abilities. As Mr. Edwin Tong and some parents have rightly pointed out, students with strong general academic abilities would already be able to qualify for the school with their PSLE results. As part of this refinement, schools will discontinue the use of general academic ability tests in DSA selection by 2018. These tests are used by some schools as a standardized assessment of applicants' general reasoning and problem-solving skills. While they allow for a comparison of students' abilities, they also inevitably put undue focus on general academic abilities rather than identifying specific strengths. Schools will continue to focus on identifying sporting talent, artistic talent, or academic talent in specific domains, for instance, the languages, math, or science. Schools can conduct the selection by a range of assessment tools, including interviews, trials, auditions, and subject tests. They will also consider the applicant's overall portfolio and achievements. A second change we will make is to simplify the DSA application process. Today, students have to apply to individual schools, each with their own application process. From 2019 DSA exercise onwards, students will be able to submit their applications through a centralized online application portal using a common application form. Schools will also have to put out clear information about the DSA categories and selection criteria on their websites. This will help students and parents make better informed choices. I look forward to seeing more primary school students take up these increased opportunities to develop their strengths in a more holistic fashion.